guys. I am Patty Elhoff, the author of Upcycle with Decoupage, available on Amazon. Also on my website, Upcycle with Decoupage. And today, I'm going to turn this adorable kettle. Into this. And before we get started, I just want to mention that I have a Facebook page called Upcycle with Decoupage. My website is upcyclewithdecoupage.v as in Victor, P as in Patty, web.com. I'll put the link into the description of this video if you'd like to go over and purchase napkins, supplies. While you're over there, you can still shop all over Amazon for whatever you need. If you go through my website, you can get a few of my supplies and a few of anything else that you need. Now that all of that is out of the way, here's the first thing that I did with this kettle. I took chalk paint. Sometimes people ask me, do I have to use chalk paint? The reason I'm using chalk paint, for one, it gives a very matte, velvety finish, which is beautiful. The other is that chalk paint can go on any surface without prep work. Actually, I'm not sure about plastic. So I painted this, I put it aside to dry. Decoupage the painted and dried kettle. You may want to keep your plastic wrap, just plain old saran wrap, aside. And I'm going to take my brush and apply some decoupage glue. It's a good idea to lay your patterns down first to see where you would like them. When you're happy with that, then you can go ahead and apply some decoupage glue. And this is a separated napkin. It's already been taken apart, so this is just the top portion. Now you want to make sure your hands are completely dry. You don't have any decoupage glue on them. And you can pull the napkin a little bit to keep the wrinkles out. And you can lightly press down. If you would feel more comfortable using the saran wrap, you can. You can bunch up some saran wrap and press it down, because sometimes your fingers get tacky as you're doing this and it will tear the work. And when you're working on a curved surface, an area like this can easily wrinkle, and sometimes the wrinkle looks okay. Sometimes you may just want to take your decoupage scissors, those little small curved ones, and right where you're going to see the crease, you can just put a cut in there. And then with your dry fingers, you can press down. And where I cut it, I'm going to overlap it just a little bit. So what I'm going to do is follow my pattern, continue to decoupage around here.
Thank you.
to use this dampened paintbrush again to remove any of these loose ends. And now, before I put another coat of decoupage glue over the whole surface, I'm going to take my stamp pad. I am just dabbing parts of this stamp into a waterproof pad, and I'm not embossing, I'm just making a little more of a design around the pot in a color that either matches or complements what we have here. And all I'm doing is just pressing down part of the stamp and rolling it so that it just puts this little tiny element here. If you've got a little piece that goes on the lid like this, I had to unscrew this off. This is wooden, but you can see it's very small and it could be a little hard to decoupage now. So I'm going to cut out some of these berries. And what you'll want to do is put decoupage glue on your surface. Now don't glob the glue on. It's important that you put a thin coat of decoupage glue over the surface where you want to decoupage. Now you'll place the piece down . Then you want to take your artist's brush, this very thin brush, dip it in some water, and you'll want to paint this on. I feel like this camera is not focusing. Is it focused or is it me? Looks a little blurry. You'll want to paint this on. So with the wet brush, it helps the napkin to lay down where you want it, even in these ridges. And there's already decoupage glue down. So it seems like you're painting this on. Now there are no wrinkles. There's decoupage glue underneath. And because this is wet, it's just going to take a little bit longer to dry, but not very long at all because these napkins are so thin. And this leaf is already dry. You can see how I put it under the bottom and around the top. So for any small sections that you have on your kettle, the handle, the top, even if your kettle is rather small, you can do this if you've got a ridge or a bump or a place that it's a little bit tricky to work on. Now I'm going to put the final coat of decoupage glue over the whole kettle. Then I'm going to put a top coat over it once the decoupage glue dries. And I'll show you how everything looks once we're all done. Okay, there is our completed tea kettle. Pretty nice when you consider that it looked like this. $2.50 for it in the Salvation Army, and now we have an adorable little Christmas. I guess you could say it's an ornament. It's a bit larger than an ornament. So for now, guys, thank you so much for subscribing. Thank you for going through my website to order your products and supplies. That's www.upcyclewithdecoupage.vpweb.com. And if you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comment section below. Don't forget about Upcycle with Decoupage on Facebook. I'm glad to help you out with any of your questions. And I will be back next week with another video. Thanks again, guys. Bye-bye.